ग्रीटिंग्स कोडिंग वाइजर्स, कृष्णा शर्मा हियर फ्रॉम क्रेडिट एंड वेलकम बैक टू द 17th मैजिकल एपिसोड ऑफ अवर जावास्क्रिप्ट सीरीज। टुडे वी आर डाइविंग इनटू द हैंड्स ऑन कोडिंग एक्सरसाइज वेयर यू विल हैव द चांस टू पुट योर जावास्क्रिप्ट स्किल टू द टेस्ट। आफ्टर द चैलेंज स्टिक अराउंड एज वी वॉक थ्रू द सॉल्यूशन टूगेदर। सो ग्रैब योर कोडिंग बैंड्स एंड लेट द एडजस्टमेंट बिगिन। सो this is our coding exercise. Today's magical challenge involves creating a spellbook application using JavaScript. So here are the tasks. So first task is create an array named spellbook containing at least 5 magical spells. So this is very easy. So next is task 2, write a function named addSpell that takes a new spell as an argument and add it to the spellbook. And let's move to task 3. Write a function named removeSpell that takes a spell as an argument and remove it from the spellbook. So this is two tasks for adding a spellbook and removing the spellbook. So next is write a function named findSpells that takes a spell as an argument and check if it exists in the spellbook. So this is last but not the least, task 5. Display the current spellbook array in the console after each operation done. So I hope you this understand all the tasks. So this is our exercise. You have to just go in your text editor and solve this task and put your JavaScript skill into the task. So here we have the solution. So first you have to go and solve this by own. So this is coding solution. Welcome back coding heroes. I hope you get a magical time attempting the exercise. Let's now unveil the enchanted solution. So task 1. For task 1 is the creating the spellbook array. So first we will create an spellbook array. So this is very easy. Let spellbook with of array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 at least 5 characters. So here we have a task 2 solution. Task 2 is implementing the addSpell function. So in the addSpell function, we have to write a function named addSpell that takes a new spell as an argument and add it to the spellbook. So this is very, you have to just, this is very easy. You have to just use a push operation here. Function and function name addSpell, and in the argument you just pass new spell and dot and spellbook dot push new spell. So this will push the new spell into the addSpell. So here we have a task 3, crafting a removeSpell function. So in the removeSpell function, we have to write a function named removeSpell that takes an spell as an argument and remove it from the spellbook. So here first we have to find the index of that spell. So first we write the function removeSpell, spell to remove, this is argument, and then add index is equal to spellbook dot index of. So this will find the index of spell to remove, and then if index is not equal to -1, so means if index is exist, so spellbook dot splice index from the index and one element will remove from this spellbook. I hope you understand this. So our task 4. Task 4 is for finding. Write a function named findSpell that takes a spell as an argument and check if it exists in the spellbook. So we have to just find the here include. We will use the here. We will write a function with a name findSpell, spell to find argument, and then return spellbook.includes. If spellbook include, then it will return. Then we have the last task for displaying the spellbook after each operation. So here we will have a function display spellbook. This is just a printing after every operation of the spellbook. So we have completed this. Now let's perform some magical operation on this task. This is very interesting exercise. I hope you get this. So first we will adding the spell in the array. So add spell Spotify and then display spell book. So just run this. So you can see this here, we Spotify is added in this array. I hope you get this. Then we will remove a spell. So first we will see this. We have this explanimous spell. We will remove from them with using this function remove spell. So we will just display this. So you can see this here. Here is not the this character. This is string. I hope you get this. Then next we will check if it is spell exists in the spell book or not. Elmora in the spell book or not. Just see this. Yeah, is Elmora in this? Yes, true. So Elmora is presented in the array. I hope you get this. And there you have it. Coding heroes, we have successfully conjured our magical spell book using JavaScript. I encourage you to try out the exercise on your own. And if you faced any challenges any question, drop them in the comment below. Coding is all about exploration and learning, and together we can master the interesting world of JavaScript. If you found this exercise helpful, hit the like button, subscribe for more coding magics, and share your thoughts below. Until next time, may your code be magical and happy coding.